Hello, welcome. We're so glad to have you here today to be able to celebrate our graduates from a number of different years here. So first, I just want to briefly introduce myself. My name is Laura Reimer, and I'm the director of Howie the Harp Peer Training Program. Thank you. I started my career here at Community Access 10 years ago when I began working as a peer at Community Access's Crisis Respite Center. I was then hired by the previous program director of Howie the Harp, Lene Brown, to begin working as the employment coordinator at Howie the Harp. That was one of my favorite jobs ever, and I loved working with Lene because she really helped me to grow to where I am today. After working at Howie the Harp, I moved on to work as the program director of one of Community Access's supportive housing programs, where I worked for 5 years. And then I transitioned back to Howie the Harp, where I've been in the role of the program director for the last year. But that's enough about me, because we're here today to celebrate the accomplishments of our Howie the Harp graduates. And this is a very special graduation, because while ordinarily Howie the Harp holds a graduation every year, we, of course, were not able to hold a graduation for a number of years due to COVID-19. So this is the first time that we're able to hold a graduation and since October of 2019. And today we are celebrating 7 classes of students who graduated from Howie the Harp. We are celebrating students from July of 2019 all the way through February of 2023. And of course, COVID had a significant impact on the operations of Howie the Harp. The classroom space usually holds 40 students at the start of the class, and it does not allow for social distancing. So the staff at Howie the Harp had to pivot, much as we all had to do at that time. Students from the fall of 2019 were transitioning into their internships around the onset of COVID, so the staff had to reimagine what internships in a COVID world could look like. Some students were actually able to complete internships, even if on a primarily remote basis. One way or another, the staff at HTH were committed to providing ongoing support to students while adapting the requirements of the program to meet the ever-changing needs of our students. Out of this need to adapt, Howie the Harp staff created a new model of remote learning referred to as Howie the Harp Bootcamp. Then, once vaccines became available and COVID numbers began reducing, the staff began planning to return to in-person learning. But before returning to the office, the Howie the Harp offices were completely renovated. The space was given a brand new computer room, a new kitchen break room, new office spaces, and a new classroom, which is now equipped with high-tech audio-visual technology. Howie the Harp began in-person learning in the new classroom in July of 2022, but this time with a small class size in order to ease back into the return of in-person activities. In February of 2023, Howie the Harp accepted its first class of approximately 40 students since before the pandemic. Since then, we have been working as a team to implement a variety of changes. For one, we began editing and condensing some of our curriculum into its key parts, and in doing so, we were able to reduce our classroom length to 14 weeks, which enables us to now hold 3 Howie the Harp class cycles per year instead of 2. In addition, we have begun to offer some electives at Howie the Harp, which have been open not only to current Howie the Harp students, but also to Howie the Harp graduates. Through Community Access's relationship with Computers for People, we have been able to begin offering a computer elective to students, which meets an important need that we had been finding amongst many of our students. We have also been able to begin offering an elective that helps prepare students for the Academy of Peer Services online modules, an elective that helps students with writing, and an elective we call Peer Arts, which teaches our students about a variety of art forms and how they can be utilized as a tool to aid in one's recovery. As Howie the Harp staff continue to rethink how we go about the work that we do, we are guided daily by the work of Howard Geld and others before us who started the peer movement. We are so thankful to be able to celebrate the accomplishments of the students who come before you today. These students not only completed the Howie the Harp program, but did so during some unbelievably trying times in our collective history. Let's please give them all a round of applause for everything they have accomplished. Next, I'm pleased to introduce to you the CEO of Community Access and valued supporter of Howie the Harp, Ms. Cal Hedigan.
Thank you, Laura. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome. My name is Cal Hedigan, and I have the honor of leading Community Access. Howie the Harp graduation ceremonies are among my favorite occasions, a chance to shine a spotlight on all the graduates and the hard work it took to get here. I want to thank each and every one of you, friends, family members, and supporters, for being here for this celebration. As Laura mentioned, it's been a while since we were able to do this. So a special thanks to all the graduates from years past for showing up this afternoon to gather in community to celebrate your achievements. For those of you who may not know, Community Access is a nonprofit whose mission is focused on supporting people living with mental health concerns move forward with their lives and thrive. We do this through supportive housing, training and education, advocacy, and other healing-focused services. We approach the work from a human rights perspective and understand that people who have been diagnosed with a mental health concern do not lose their agency or their ability to make meaningful contributions to our society. We have always understood that mental health services must be rooted in choice and true partnership between those who provide services and those who receive them. When Howie the Harp Advocacy Center was founded in 1995, it was the first comprehensive peer training program in the country. The center was and remains a revolutionary place of opportunity. It originated from the vision of Howard Geld, also known as Howie the Harp, as you all well know. Howie was a fierce advocate for mental health system transformation and the power of self-help and peer support, as well as being Community Access's very first director of advocacy. In 1993, Howie the Harp wrote, "To find out what people truly need, ask them." Brilliant, right? He went on to say that slowly, enlightened mental health professionals and researchers are realizing that they must listen to their clients and meet clients' needs as the client defines them. Howie was spot on about a couple of things in that statement. We need to listen to people, and change happens slowly. The mental health system today is still in need of transformation. That is why the Howie the Harp Workforce Training Program and the work that the graduates go on to do is so important. Since its founding, Howie the Harp has trained over 2,000 peers for roles within the human services sector. Having peers in the workforce is critical to creating the mental health system that we all so desperately need. To all the graduates we are celebrating here today, congratulations. Bravo. Each one of you is a change agent, part of the wider system transformation that we need. Your work will be essential to realizing the vision of a mental health system where people are listened to, and we meet people's needs as they define them. A system where true partnership between providers and recipients is the norm. I have no doubt that you will make a profound impact in people's lives. and I cannot wait to see what you achieve next. I also want to take a moment to recognize some supporters and partners of Community Access who make Howie the Harp possible. The New York City Department of Health and Mental Hygiene, Anthem Blue Cross Blue Shield Health Plus, the Abbott and Lila Stillman Foundation, the Eugene M. Lang Foundation, the Jean and Louis Dreyfus Foundation, and KKR Citizenship. And a very special shout out to the entire staff at Howie the Harp for all they do every day to make the program what it is. Thank you. So in closing, thank you again, everyone, for coming here today to join us in this celebration. And with that, I will turn the microphone over to someone who's going to introduce amazing speakers or an amazing speaker. Maybe both.
Good afternoon, everyone. First, I want to congratulate everyone here. For those of you who do not know me, I'm Lyle Schmerz, and I'm a career coach at Howie the Harp, and I'm also a graduate. So it is my pleasure to introduce to you Kim O'Malley, one of the graduates from the July 2019 class. It is of no surprise that Kim has been chosen for the honor of speaker for her class. You will be hearing from her soon, but I can tell you that she is someone that has a mindset of continual growth and development. Kim is always keeping busy for her well-being and to tailor herself into the professional she wants to be. However, Kim was not always like this. Like most of the graduates here, she needed to overcome many challenges and obstacles to become the person she is today. Her hard work has paid off, not only for today, but for her future, as Kim has plans for higher education and to finish some certifications and credentials to serve peers more comprehensively. I congratulate Kim on today and wish her well on her plans to obtain her bachelor's degree. Without further ado, I introduce to you Kim O'Malley.
Hello, everyone. Hi, fellow graduates, family, friends, HTH staff. Thank you for having us here today. It's been a long road, but we're all here. My name is Kim O'Malley, and I am a certified state peer specialist, a recovery coach, and one class away from obtaining my KSAC team. My experience at HTH was life-changing because now I am employed at CASA's New Start, where I love and could help guide individuals in the right direction according to their own pathways. I have been employed for approximately 14 months full-time, and I am also employed at a respite part-time. When I completed HTH, COVID-19 started, and I was not able to complete an internship. However, I began working as a peer program specialist in June 2020, and I have been continuously working up until today. Prior to HTH, I was a participant at the Bridge. A lot of my peers there didn't know where to turn and didn't have a lot of support. I decided to create a group with peers leading peers that focus on the 8 dimensions of wellness and developing support systems. I created and facilitated my own participant-led groups. The people around me began seeing that I was already beginning to do peer work, but on a volunteer basis. So they recommended that I attend Howie the Harp. When I started Howie the Harp, I was excited and looking forward to learning more skills. The bridge has been extremely supportive and continues to support me. I felt a little shy when I started at Howie the Harp, but over time I became less shy. I'm still a little shy in some ways, but being in the class motivated me to get to where I am today. The classroom experience taught me how to excel in many areas. I met some great people along the way, and we developed relationships with one another. There are people from my class who I still stay in contact with, and they are now a part of my support system, both personally and professionally. It was an ever-changing experience. It made me focus on myself and focus on my mental health. It helped teach me how to help others with their mental health and help them to improve lives by providing support. I learned a lot from many of the trainers. Learning about the RAP plan was useful because it promoted health and wellness. It helped to decrease burnout and compassion fatigue. I incorporate the wellness plan, the RAP plan, in my life by adding different aspects of it, such as self-care, meditation, prayer, family, and friends. I incorporate it into my life by encouraging participants to engage in self-care. I also learned about motivational interviewing and active listening, which helps me to show empathy for others and helps them to feel more comfortable speaking to me. Because they don't feel judged, Pam's writing class helped me to write effectively. It helped me become a better writer, so I use those skills at work now. I think peer work makes a difference in so many ways, which as it's a collaborative, person-centered, strength-based process which offers support and guidance to many individuals. My work as a peer for the past 5 years has been fulfilling and rewarding. And I absolutely love my career, and I am looking forward to college in 2024. Because I am planning to start a bachelor's degree in marriage and family dynamics. And then I plan to pursue my master's degree in marriage and family counseling. Hopefully to incorporate it into my job currently at CASE's New Start. My first job was part-time with ACMH's apartment treatment program, and then I worked part-time at Fountain House Art Studio. Then I worked for New Horizon Counseling Center. All of my experiences in those jobs led me to gaining the skills necessary to work in my position within CASE's. Emotionally, I am in a good place. I'm happy. I am glad to be where I am now. My favorite part of my job is meeting participants because I think we are all in it together. We are all interconnected in different ways. I am committed to helping people learn how to build healthier relationships with family and healthier lives. I believe in taking a collaborative approach to helping clients reach their goals. I'm passionate about creating resources and individuals struggling with substance use, mental health concern, and homelessness. I am interested in participating in workshops, speaking engagements. What my peer work means to me is how I engage with my peers and represent one one's true and whole self in a workplace. I believe achieving psychological presence involves the person investing values, beliefs, thoughts, and feelings. I feel more engaged as a peer because I like connecting and influencing how that could make a difference in someone's life. I am now more motivated in the work because of my own aspirations and dreams to complete my degree. HTH has equipped my peers and I to become future leaders within the work we do every day. They have motivated us and taught us to be fully engaged in the work we do and maintain all aspects of our life, such as emotionally, mentally, physically, spiritually, environmentally, financially, intellectually, socially, vocationally, and occupationally. I feel a strong connection to my organization, and so I work hard to be creative and show improvements and be productive. I have job satisfaction and commitment, and I will work hard to achieve my personal and professional goals and continue to nurture a growth mindset within myself.
Okay, I'm gonna introduce our next class speaker. This individual is from the class of February 2023, and her name is Lonnie Shepherd. Prior to coming to HTH, Lonnie had worked for the airline industry for many years, and she also worked in local government. On the side, Lonnie works as a freelance visual artist and graphic designer. When Lonnie was a student here, she acted as a great example of what it means to be a peer. Lonnie was candid, open, respectful, professional, and wise. She leaned into peer values and gave space for her classmates to speak their truth. Lonnie was very supportive of her classmates and garnered all of their respect. After completing the classroom training, Lonnie successfully completed her internship with Community Access's Apartment Treatment Program. And recently, Lonnie accepted a peer specialist position on an ACT team with the Jewish Board of Children and Family Services. Lonnie is set to start her new job on February 5th, which is a year to the day she started at Howie the Harp. Please welcome to the stage Lonnie Shepherd.
Graduates, it feels good to say that. Does anybody know the song from the musical Wicked called Defying Gravity? Metaphorically speaking, that's what we do every day. That's what we did before coming to Howie. That's what we did during our training and internships. And that's what we do in our jobs. We defy low expectations. We defy obstacles and barriers. We defy boxes and mental chains that try to keep us on a short leash. We defy gravity. Remember the beginning? Remember how you felt applying to Howie the Harp? Then the interview? Then waiting to hear if you were accepted? Remember going to class and wondering some days if you would make it through? I remember meeting all kinds of people from so many walks of life, and a camaraderie grew between us because of this shared experience at Howie. There was a great deal of material to read through, listen to, and videos to watch, both in class and from the Academy of Peer Services online. We had to understand and begin to internalize things like active listening, motivational interviewing, and trauma-informed care. I remember the Wellness Recovery Action Plan and Sarah Brown, having to role play the things we learned and doing group facilitation were a little scary and challenging. Still, we did it. We were supportive of each other, and that's what got many of us through. At times, going to class while doing the APS online training felt overwhelming, especially when combined with all the things going on in our personal lives. Every single one of us here was persistent, and Howie changed us. We had to open our minds to all kinds of ideas, including how we thought about ourselves and our peers. We had to reevaluate our preconceptions. We stretched our minds and learned new capabilities. Some of us went through homelessness, hospitalization, the loss of loved ones, and there were also births and new bonds, new goals, new possibilities. I know for sure Pam's classes on writing and documentation in human services made me think more deeply about how to interpret any given scenario from a provider's perspective. I remember Tony's guidance during the whole process. He was a level head who explained to all of us the realities of peer support in down-to-earth terms we could understand, and a guiding force throughout the training process. Lyle and Cedar took us through many topics in class and gave us guidance on how to navigate through the experience of learning peer support, internships, and the job market. Laura explained many aspects of peer training and had an open door policy for asking questions. Mainly, I felt more competent to handle supporting another human being as a peer. Going through Howie the Harp has aided me in feeling more confident in my abilities as a peer support specialist. It has given me tools for utilizing life experiences to support others who are on their own unique journey. Going through my own internship at Community Access Treatment Apartment Program caused me to reassess what I thought was an aging memory. Because of the importance of talking to participants and documenting what I was doing, I came to realize that memorizing the details of these interactions made my mind sharper due to the importance of the circumstances in the lives of those same individuals. I have been a good listener throughout my life, but Howie taught me how to fine-tune that listening. Listening, compassion, acceptance, and respect go a long way in anyone's recovery. During the training, this theme repeated itself over and over again, whether we were receiving a presentation on harm reduction, learning to support individuals to create their own goals, or how to enable everyone to be heard in a group setting. I have maintained a connection with multiple fellow classmates and met numerous other Howie the Harp graduates in other settings. When times are tough, having these individuals in my life has pulled me and them through. It is like running a marathon and having other runners by your side, and at other times, having folks cheering you from the sidelines, telling you, you can make it. That means the world, because it lets us know we are not alone. We belong in the world. We have value. Our lives can make a positive impact on those around us. Similarly to our predecessors who started the ex-patient movement that created peer support, we knock down barriers within ourselves and the confines of what society thought we were capable of doing. Learning the history of the peer movement gave me inspiration. Pat Deegan is such a role model that I draw on for inspiration. She was diagnosed with schizophrenia in her youth and told she would never amount to anything, that she would have to accept institutionalization for the rest of her life. Well, she definitely proved her detractors wrong. She pushed back on the label and constrictions of a diagnosis and went on to become a psychiatrist who became a force for great change in the world. From time to time, I think to myself that if she could do what she did, then I have possibilities for my life. studying the history of the peer movement had a great impact on me. We reached out to each other and lifted each other up with the help and guidance of the staff at Howie. Individuals like Tony, Laura, Cedar, and Lyle were living examples of what we could achieve. And we could talk to them. Maintaining contact with staff for guidance has helped me to move forward. I know there's hope for a better future. It does not mean everything is easy. There are still plenty of challenges ahead. There are still struggles that we all deal with currently, but we are here. We are standing in our truths, our triumphs, and our tragedies. It's okay to have doubts. It's okay to have fears. Pushing through those things is the definition of courage, and we are all doing it in our own unique ways. Howie equipped us with skills and knowledge for working in the peer support field. There are multiple aspects to working as a peer provider, and we gained a solid foundation from the training and presentations by providers in the field. In many industries, excellent oral and written communication skills are a necessity. The ability to write Medicaid billable notes, SOAP notes, and generic notes were a hallmark of the training at Howie. Pam drilled us in standard business grammar, not only for progress notes, but for things such as cover letters and resumes. Thank you, Pam. Thank you. I am still a work in progress, but I and many of my fellow graduates are grateful to her for her generosity and knowledge of writing effectively. Yes. By working as peers in different capacities, we are living proof that out of pain and darkness, light can emerge. We can now use all those experiences of temporary defeat to help others. We have the privilege of turning darkness into a tool for healing. When I was homeless, I learned a confidence that I had never known, because it did not destroy me. It was not the end. I am strong, and so are you. Several years ago, I was close to obtaining a degree in graphic design. I got hit by a car while walking across the street, and things began to spiral down. At first, I thought my life was over, but eventually I realized I was catastrophizing. I was still alive. So even if I had to reinvent my life, there was still life in me. I started reaching out to opportunities and started putting one foot in front of the other once more. Some wonderful people and experiences came into my life. I obtained supportive housing, and then Howie the Harp came along. The peer support industry is still like a big secret. I really did not know what it was until I became a student. It is a movement growing across the city, the country, and the world, and a great need exists for what we do. Just think about how we as individuals might have been affected if we had had peer support early in our lives. Well, now we can all act as that hand reaching out and lifting up, that person standing by someone's side so they are not alone. Each of us is a light in the darkness. There is more to life than what society once thought, and we are living proof. The root system in a forest is a network, a living, breathing network. Something I have learned since graduating is that Howie the Harp and all of us together working in different organizations are a network. Every time we make a connection to another person, that network grows. And that network is there to help us help each other. Finding jobs, building an organization, finding support, growing a community, that is all a part of networking. We are connected to each other. Let's keep the network growing. Thank you.
It is my honor to introduce to you Christina Brown. One of the graduates from the July 2022 class. Christina has been chosen for the Student Commitment Award. And soon you will see why Christina, as she shares her story and journey with us all. Not only is Christina strong, tenacious, and creative, but she has a never give up and can do attitude that is contagious. For example, when Christina shared her internship experiences during our weekly internship support group meetings, she would light up as she described her work. Her internship site, JASA, was a wonderful place for her to grow as a peer and professional. Christina took her aptitude for writing poetry and the arts and merged it with her peer training. With these two strengths combined, she was unstoppable and really provided the seniors at JASA a wonderful experience to grow and be a kid again. Christina also had a surprise when going through the Howie the Harp training program. I won't ruin it for her, so I will let Christina tell you all that part. I congratulate Christina, and without any more delay, I introduce to you Christina Brown.
Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to take the time right now to express gratitude to the wonderful people at Community Access and the Howie the Harp Peer Advocacy Training Program. Let me begin by saying my journey has not always been easy, but thanks to the kindness and encouragement through the struggles, I am able to stand here victorious. Amen. Right now, I will tell you a little bit about myself and my journey. For several years in my 20s, things began to change and became more difficult. It was at that time that I was directed to the Brooklyn Community Service, or BCS PROS program. Like everyone here at Community Access, they were just warm, open, and encouraging. I took my recovery quite seriously and began to get noticed. The resident peer specialist and fellow Howie the Harp graduate named Thomas took me under his wing and encouraged me to apply to Howie. I was accepted, and the rest is history. We do not necessarily expect hardships like mental illness in life, but the Howie the Harp program lives what it teaches by focusing on strengths. I felt like a winner just sitting in class every day, knowing I was getting a world-class education. I love to write poetry. I love to write poetry and do art, and I was allowed and encouraged to read a poem once in a while before class. That increased my comfort and connection with my classmates. That was important to me. But other than that, Tony would always say, "Life is going to life." And for me, it did in a big way. During my training, I found out I was pregnant, very pregnant. At that time, the loving, caring, and encouragement I received will stay with me forever. The only thing I heard was, "How can we support you?" I was so glad for this because I knew I had to complete the program. I don't go halfway on anything. I went to class every day, listened, and studied. I only took a day once in a while to go to prenatal care. I would like to thank my mother, who's sitting over there. I would like to thank my mother tremendously for driving me in her Honda Pilot, which is now in car heaven, all the way from Brooklyn to Harlem before and after I gave birth to my daughter, Amara. In fact, 1 week after a C-section, I was back in class. I just had to be. HTH's commitment to me was equal to my commitment to them. And by the way, Amara told me to tell you that she'll be expecting her Howie the Harp certificate in the mail since she had to sit through training too. After my daughter's birth, things turned around quickly and I was accepted to do an internship with a company called JASA. Hello, friend. Yet another wonderful experience. I put forth my best effort and truly cared about my work, and they appreciated it. We still keep in touch. So what about today? All of these trainings and preparations have led me to gainful employment at the Brooklyn Community Services, or BCS CHAMP program, as a youth peer advocate. If those letters BCS sound familiar, it's because BCS is the same place where I go to for my mental health recovery program. In fact, it's the same site and building. So that means I walked into BCS as a patient and participant, and now I am walking in as an employee. My first employment in over 11 years. Things do really come full circle, especially with commitment. Thank you. And finally, I wanted to say that in the spirit of being of service to my community, I would like to offer information about the Brooklyn Community Service CHAMP program. It is a mental health program for young adults aged 18 to 26. Now you can feel free to ask me for a flyer, especially if you live or know someone who lives in Brooklyn. I do this because a life of service is a life well lived, just like Howie taught me. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. So my name is Tony Wright. I'm the coordinator of training for Howie the Harp. I have the esteem of giving two awards, our commitment award for trainer and also commitment award for internship site. But first, let me start with our trainer award. The first recipient that I would like to speak to and about is a young lady who first coming to Howie the Harp was really, really honest about her experience with going to multiple programs and services and felt that Howie the Harp was just going to be like the rest of them. This wonderful individual, her name is Giovanna Mark, who's a graduate of our spring 2018 cohort. Soon after completing training with Howie the Harp, Ms. Marks went on to intern at CASES, which led into a full-time job. Ms. Marks is a certified and licensed peer specialist. She received her master's in public administration since completing Howie the Harp and is currently pursuing her doctorate degree. As if that is not enough, Ms. Mark started her own not-for-profit agency. Agency is called Mark Resources, which stands for Multi-Assistance Resource Center. A full site of services are delivered through Mark's Resource Center, which is located in Harlem, New York City. Services are designed to strengthen the fabric of worn and distressed communities, bridge opportunity gaps, and equip underserved people with the tools for success. So it's no wonder that this award would go to the incomparable Ms. Giovanna Mark.
Hi everyone, I'm Giovanna. Never done this before. I had a whole thing written out, but I think it's better if I just kind of freestyle. You know, when I came to Howie the Harp, I was broken. I had just lost my second son to no fault of my own. And the thing that I took with me from Howie the Harp, I mean, Like, I had been agoraphobic since my son passed away in 2015. Hardly came out the house. When I started Howie the Harp, I was in a such dark place. I mean, I had hoodies all the time. Like, I didn't want to be seen. My husband would pick me up at the door and drop me off at the door. But they gave me hope. They made me feel like I can be someone, like I'm not my diagnosis. Like, don't believe everyone who's telling you that you're a psycho, you're schizo, or you're this, you're that. They gave me hope, I believed. And that's what they did for me. And for all the graduates here, if you don't believe, just look at me. Just look at me, like I'm doing my PhD. This is after a doctor told me I should not go to school. So I wanna say thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, because if it wasn't Howie the Harp, like Anthony explained, I have been through numerous programs in New York City just looking to get fixed. And when I got to Howie the Harp, you know, I didn't take it serious at the beginning until maybe like the third week. It was like, oh, wow, you know, that light bulb lit up. Oh, no, I can really get something out of this. This is totally different than what I've been through in the last 30 years. You know, I didn't have to be in a hospital. I could be a mother. I can work a real job, which is something that I didn't do in like 10 years. So I just want to say thank you. I don't know what else to say, but I'm honored and I'm so happy that I came through this program, because if I didn't, I wouldn't be here today. Thank you so much. Thank you.
The next commitment award I'd like to give to internship site. This is recognized as Ms. Patricia Harvisham Brown, who's the Director of Intensive Mobile Treatment, IMT, at CASIS. Ms. Patricia and the team at CASIS has supported HCA's peers in their journeys from internships to employment. She's advocated for HTH graduates to have internship placements opportunities across all the multiple departments that exists within CASIS. CASIS provides exposure for interns who are interested in the multiple layers involved and supported individuals who are justice involved. Quite often following internships, HTH interns are provided with an opportunity to become employees. This also provides them with a salary position and an opportunity for growth within the agency while they focus on their personal and professional development. Ms. Patricia is not only a great employment ally, but we also call on her for information, resources, and also to brainstorm just how better support our peers in all of the CASIS internship sites. Patricia's always been present, willing to collaborate with us as we support our peers. For this reason, and many, many more, we'd like to recognize Ms. Patricia for her commitment and partnership with Howie the Harp.
Good afternoon, everyone. First, I'd like to congratulate all the graduates from all the years that have gone through Howie the Harp. You all are fantastic. I love you. I don't know you all, but I love you all. I mean that sincerely. I want to thank my commitment and our collaboration with Howie the Harp. We're on 8th floor, they're on the 12th floor. Sometimes I just take the elevator upstairs. I just need to share and talk and see people. But we have been able, I came to CASIS in 2016, and I made a commitment at that time that we were going to bring interns on. And they were gonna come from Howie the Harp. People don't realize the relationship and the benefit that peer interns and peers can have in working with the population that we work with. People don't always wanna hear about a social worker and their degree and stuff. They wanna hear from someone that's walked the walk and talked the talk and been there. And the peers are the ones who do that for us every single day. I am so proud of you all, I really am. I thank you all for being peers, because you are what helps us engage with our clients in the community, and I'm just so, so pleased to be here. Congratulations to you all, and I look forward to hiring the next batch also. Thank you.
Thank you. We're almost done with the first half of our celebration. I just want to acknowledge the graduates and to extend again a special congratulations on a job very well done. We're so extremely proud of you. We'd also like to just recognize and honor for who this has all started, which is Mr. Howard Geld, AKA Howie the Harp. Howie recognized that transforming the mental health system required the full integration of people in recovery into the workforce, and that these workers needed the skills and knowledge to be effective change agents, as Cal has said. Unfortunately, Howie passed away before the center opened its doors, but we honored him by naming the center after him. Although we're a small team at HTH, we would not be able to do the amazing work that we do without the support of our collaborating trainers who have stepped up to enhance our curriculum as we grow and expand as a program. We'd also like to give recognition to our internship sites, all of them that support us at Howie the Harp and our peers, fellow colleagues at CA, our board of directors, as well as our trustees. We wouldn't be able to do all of this without the support of an amazing team who help us daily. So thank you very much. So at this time, we're going to take a little small recess. Feel free to mingle around, have some refreshments. We're going to prep and get ready to give our graduates their certificates. So just bear with us. Thank you very much, everyone. And so for those that don't know, we have a tradition at Howie the Harp. And it was brought to my attention that I was remiss in doing our tradition. So I must honor the wishes of the class, and we have to do our wheeze. Ready, graduates? One, two, three.
Wheeze!
One, two, three.
Wheeze!
One, two, three. And that's how he does it. Awesome, grads. So I think we're ready to begin. Maestro, if we can have our music. Representing the July 2019 class, I'm going to call the name of graduates for all that have completed the program. But those who are here will receive their certificate, and we will hold on to the certificates to make sure they get to those that were not able to make it. Andre Tana, Bernard Huffman, Karina Castro, Charles de San Pedro Jr., Edward Warren, Afua McLean, Georgia Mariduena, Hector Prince, Yvette Lugo, Janine Guzman, Jing Yi, Kia Devereaux, Kim O'Malley, Lisa Buckley, Malika Williams, Melissa Vasquez, Maureen Gordon, Nicole Duncan, Orlando Nunez, Roisin Bonjour, Roger Percelli, Ryan Kennedy, Sarah Ortiz, Shanling Perry, Sharon McLean, and Tashira James. Representing the January 2020 class, Avram Groper, David Parker, Felix Guzman, Glenn Patrick Mejia, Hannah Markowitz, Aisha Hamilton, Jill Peace, John Omberger, Lila Graham, Luz Rios, Margaret Galanek, Margot Galli, Norman Mishu Jr., Amalolo
Olga Toyumbe, Opal Warwick, and Vanessa Ward. Representing our boot camp spring 2021 class, Aisha Wax, Anita Sangakala, Anna Snap, Annie Gonzalez, Brandon Daniels, Bryn Packard, Daniel Victor, David McCullers, Edwin Rozia, Eric Shapiro, Gonzalo Kuzma, Ian McGovern, Ian Ramsey, Jaylene Edelman, Jesse Garcia, Jill Whitman, Katie Wagner, Karim Dogan, Kessiana Harrison, Lisa Spencer, Louis Gravely, Lynn Dudley, Michelle Thompson, Mohammed Mohudan, and Gina Messia, Pace Lee, Precious Skinner, Rafael Nunez, Rafaleni Jimenez, Rondell Richardson, Sarah Efford, Sharon Jones, Weishong Diaz, Iana Townsend. Representing the fall 2020 boot camp class, Argy Gitiones, Jadita Simmons, Christina Harden, Devon Nash, Erica Powell, Fabio Apollon, Heavenly Sears, James Clark, Joa Correa, Josue Jean Baptiste, Kimberly Brooks, Maria Langen, Melissa Palandino, Michelle Cagna, Monique Correa, Naftali Thomas Diaz, Nelson Cabrera, Nina Graham, Richard Montavo, Seisharie Bala, Shaquisha Cloud, Cherise Southwell, Stacy Bell, Tanya Stalling, Willetta Williams, and Cesar Figueroa. Figueroa, perdón, señor. Representing the 2020-22 spring boot camp class, Abigail Wendt, Albert Cash, Amelia Jean Shen, Benjamin Jokan, Brenda Ortiz, Sierra Lockley, Dana McPhillips, Derek Rutherford, Don McAdams, Heather Christensen, Jay Gonzalez, Jeffrey Egger, Jody Lynn, Justin Moon, Kalisha Reed, Karen Smalls, Lenny Spates, Mallory Washington, Nadja Hurd, Rafaela Justiniano, Rhonda Simmons, Steven Singer, Sophronia King, Tiffany Yang, Wei Lang. Representing the July 2022 class, Andreas Meyer, Christina Brown. Delala Ferrara Nieves. Douglas Sweat. Miriam Rosenblatt. Olivia Bacchus. Billy Schimmel. Yetta Freundlich. And last but not least, representing the February 2023 class, Alderman Gomez. Christina Ching. Danaya Timberlake. Dinaja. Geetha Rathmala. Rathnamala, forgive me, Geetha. Halifang Cardo. James Velez. Elizabeth Perez. Janira Dale. Lamar McNabb. Lonnie Shepherd. Lawrence Lowe. Lisa Cable. Lanice Robinson. Marianne Butler. Miles Carrion. Rosalba Perez. Tammy Paradis. Thelma Coleman. And Travis West. How about here a round of applause for all of our graduates? On behalf of all of us at Harry the Harp, CA, our board of directors and trustees, we thank you all for coming out and celebrating this amazing occasion. We hope you get home safely, rejoice, enjoy yourselves, and again, thank you for being here.
Everyone, please stand for the alma mater. Everybody up.
Cast adrift on life's storm, feces, perfect, remove my debt. I chance to stop at an open house where strangers were heard to say, they said, Howie the Harp, this is Howie the Harp, sacred fount of information, grammar, rap, and mediation. Howie the Harp, this is Howie the Harp. Look sharp, you're at Howie the Harp, you certainly are. Navigating a paper trail, homework, we're up to our ears. Dignity and the right to responsible peers. Okay. Howie the Harp, this is Howie the Harp. Sacred thought of information, grammar, rap, and mediation. Howie the Harp, this is Howie the Harp. Look sharp, you're at Howie the Harp, you certainly are. Finals, bonding, and fun farewell. How can we leave this fair class? Still our memories will serve us well when next we are out on our Howie the Harp, this is Howie the Harp. Sacred found of information, grammar, rap, and mediation. Howie the Harp, till we're ready for harp. Look sharp, yours. Howie the Harp, it certainly is.
Thank you, everyone.
Graduates, we're going to have you up on stage so we can do a group photo. And thank you all so much for coming today and supporting our graduates. If you're a graduate, come up to the stage. We're going to do a group photo.
And a special thank you to our violinist, Michelle DeRose, who accompanied us on that wonderful selection. Thank you, Michelle.